Okay, friends. So today is a very very special day, okay? And we will have a very special lecture, right? Please just read the first line. And from beginning, I'm telling you, there are some 8 verses. There is no guarantee 8 verses. 8 verses are going to go over, okay? I will talk, then bring the refer book, what's the reference, okay? But just please see, please read it, okay? The first one, please read it. Vandeham Sachidanandam
Vandeham Sachidanandam
Vedatitam Jagadgurum
Vedatitam Jagadgurum
Nityam Purnam Nirakaram सर्वसंस्थितं
निर्गुणं सर्वसंस्थितं
परात्परतरं ध्येयं
परात्परतरं ध्येयं
नित्यमानन्दकारणं
नित्यमानन्दकारणं
हृदयाकाशमध्यस्थं
हृदयाकाशमध्यस्थं
शुद्धस्फटिकसन्निभं वन्देऽहं सच्चिदानन्दं वेदातीतं जगद्गुरुं नित्यं पूर्णं निराकारं निर्गुणं सर्वसंस्थितं परात्परतरं ध्येयं नित्यं आनन्दकारणं हृदयाकाशमध्यस्थं शुद्धस्फटिकसन्निभं एवरी वर्ड ऑफ दिस इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू सो आई डोंट नीड टू एक्सप्लेन यू अंडरस्टैंड एवरीथिंग नो प्रॉब्लम वी शैल स्टार्ट विथ बिकॉज आई वॉज थिंकिंग बिफोर कमिंग टू दिस क्लास Just I was contemplating over these verses. Very beautiful ideas came, I'll share with you. And just please relax and listen, because as I told you last night, this subject, and I've told you many other times also, this subject is very, very simple, okay? At no time you must consider it very complicated. Because this subject about yourself is the easiest of the subject. I hope you have understood it by now. You have really recognized it by now. You must see it for yourself. Only when you know how easy it is, then we shall believe how easy it is. Until that, you are not going to believe. You just Swamiji is talking. Just like Krishna talks. Like Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita, no? Rajavidya, Rajaguiham. पवित्रम इदम उत्तमम प्रत्यक्षम अवगम्यम धर्म्यम सुसुखम कर्तुम अव्ययम सुखम कर्तुम सुखम ना वेरी वेरी इजी सुखम अनायासेन कर्तुम एफर्टलेस टू बी योरसेल्फ व्हाट शुड यू डू जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट जस्ट टू बी नेचुरल जस्ट टू बी योर बॉडी व्हाट शुड यू डू But if you want a fancy dress, you have to do a lot of things. Just think of it. To be somebody, to be yourself, what should you do? In the light of all that you have understood, exposed so far, just to be yourself, what thought you should have? I am not interested in your thinking. I am not interested in what thoughts you have. Are you an engineer, doctor? PhD, FRCS, management scholar, musician, painter, artist, woodcutter. Those are all achievements. Are you getting that point, please? Those are all achievements. The thoughts that you have picked up, the expertise that you have picked up. Who you are is not a thought. Is it that difficult to understand? Think, friends. Because our mind has been very, 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 very complicated, that is why simple solutions are not recognized. It eludes us. Very recently, somebody sent me a beautiful piece of information. You know Mensa, you know that, right? Mensa, M-E-N-S-A. The guys with 140 plus IQ, they are the members. Average person say IQ is some people minus frozen, some are sub-zero, zero, 20, 30, 40, 50, like that. But these Mensa guys are the hottest property. Too sharp, 140 IQ, 140 plus. So they were having a conference in the California. Listen, it is true or false, don't ask me. Somebody sent it to me, so I'm talking about it. It might be true, might not be true. Somebody making up a joke, somebody making up a thing. That's not the point. We shall see what it is. So they are having a conference, and in between, they had a lunch to get together. So they all went for the lunch. When they went to the restaurant, they saw there are two, you know, that salt paper. Two bottles are there, one salt, one paper. Now the trouble is, in the salt thing there is pepper, and in the pepper thing there is salt. So now they wanted to find out how best you can transfer it without spilling anything. Simplest way, how can you transfer it? And of course, the best brains, they started working on it. Then they found out they can use a paper, one pipe, and one spoon. After 15-20 minutes deliberation, when they were finding it out, then that is the time the lady, the person who is the boy or a girl, whoever is serving in the restaurant, she comes in. They ask her, you know, in the salt bust, you have got the paper, in the paper you have got the salt. Then immediately, before they telling anything or complaining, this lady said, I'm really sorry. Remove the cap from here. Just change the cap. How do you change it without spilling? Just change the cap. But the very intelligent people shall look for very intelligent solution and they mess up the whole thing. How do I become myself? So go on changing the roles, go on changing the practices, go on changing the asanas, go on changing the pujas, go on changing the dharma, rituals, or go on changing the gurus, go on changing the gods, go on changing the faith. Simple, change yourself. Let them be there. Are you getting that point, please? Let everything be there. Let your thoughts be there. How are you going to get rid of the thought? Please tell me. From your childhood until now, you shall be stuck in vasana tyag. That's another trick. That you must get rid of all your vasanas. Vasanas means impressions. All your conditionings, all your thoughts. Why are you desperately Ishwara, trying your best to get rid of everything except yourself? Which one is easy? Please ask, which one is easy? Shall I dismiss everything? Or shall I understand myself? Ahankar, this ego, which has been busy dismissing everything, changing everything, negating everything, accepting, rejecting, find it extremely difficult to drop out. That is why you can see people studying for years and years and years, listening for years and years and years, yet they will say, Romba kashtam, very, very difficult. Difficult? What is difficult? I say, how to get rid of the thoughts? But who told you to get rid of the thoughts? Did I ever say you? No, no, what you are telling is true, very easy, but I heard there. Look, you heard there and telling me what you heard there. Why are you telling me that? Think of it. This tradition is so beautiful. Nowhere they have told it very, 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 very difficult. It's the easiest. But that is a easy and difficult is a relative term. To go to Mahabalipuram, difficult or easy? For whom? If you are a person who can walk, a person who can cycle, you can motorcycle, you can drive, just like that. Oh, I'm diabetic, I'm obese, heart attack. Difficult. Of course difficult. Same thing with subject. Listen carefully. Same thing with subject. Is it difficult or is it easy? Think for yourself. Is it difficult or is it easy? Depends. How much stuck you are on yourself. The person who finds security in a role, finds security, what Bhagavan, you know, Bhagavad Gita is saying of Vivek Chudamani, what is this reality? Jati niti kula gotra duragam nama rupa guna dosa varjitam desha kala visayati vartiyate brahmatattva sibhavayatmani atmani bhavayat. Think of yourself. At what? Jati niti kula gotra duram gacchati. That which is beyond jati, niti, kula, gotra, all these things you have. But suppose there is a person who is totally easy, yeah, that's right, that's not me, easy. But suppose somebody takes security in jati, somebody takes security in niti, somebody takes security in kula, what dynasty, gotram, Chandilya gotram, Kashyava Ruji, you are getting that. Or jati, this is the caste, or this is the, I'm a human being, I'm a man, I'm a woman. Oh, I'm a man, I'm a woman. You know, ridiculous. Identity does not mean only arrogance. Identity also means false humility. Are you getting that point, please? Because the person looks down upon himself so much that he cannot dare to go into temple. Looks down upon so much, then I'm an ordinary person, how can I go to a 5-star hotel? I'm such an ordinary person, how can I go to Cosmopolitan Club? How can I go into the Gymkhana Club? And another person thinks too much himself, so what? So big club, I will go. Please understand, friends, this principle works every moment of your life, every situation of your life. It's not something religious. Jati, niti, so this is what, I'm a very, you know, sort of disciplined person or indisciplined person, or I am the one who does regular pranayama or yoga, or I am doing the chanting every day. Nama, rupa, guna, dosa, barjitam, free from these limitations of nama, rupa, dosa, guna. Name, what name you have got, rupa, what forms you have got. Suppose you don't depend upon all these things, for you, easy. But somebody has found a security in one of those, very difficult. All of those, extremely difficult. It depends. Are you getting that point, please? The point is not, I hope you understand, the point is not that there is a jati, no. The point is not there is a niti, or a kula, or a gotra, or a nama, or a rupa, or a guna. They shall be there. The point is your identity. Can you drop your identity? Nobody asks you to get rid of your jati. Oh, I'm not a man, then what are you? I'm Brahman. Yes, that's true. But to be Brahman, should you get rid of it? As much you need not to hold on to it to be Brahman, you don't have to get rid of it to be Brahman. Are you getting that point? As much you don't have to give up your thought to be who you are, That much you don't have to hold on to your thought to be who you are. What a pleasure. Freedom, absolute. But suppose it is conditional. Only this guna, only this karma, only this jati, only this niti, only this kula, this gotra. What will happen? You make yourself a prisoner of your thought, prisoner of an idea, prisoner of a condition. Scriptures are not interested in that. The Guru is not interested in that. Why? One who knows this reality about himself, who he is independent of every consideration. Easiest, easiest, easiest. The simple thing. Two bottles are kept, one with salt, one with paper. Change the caps. No, you break your head, how to remove this from this one. So bottle is more important. You understand? So remove the contents, put this in that bottle, cap. Which gives you an identity, change that one. If this I is getting different types of identities from different things, the objects, the ideas, the thoughts are not wrong or right. You be yourself. How long will it take for you to understand that no role is better than the other role? Somebody is a king, somebody is a commoner. Role. Rajyam Narendrasya Bhattasya Khedaka Tayorapohe Nabhato Naraja. How beautiful Shankara writes. That is why the day you have to, if you have to go on expressing your gratitude to the gurus, you are dead. Can't open your mouth. You understand? How beautiful he says, Rajyam Narendrasya Bhattasya Khedaka. Two people, there are two human beings. One with collective upadhi, Rajyam, the kingdom, he is the king. Another also is a person with a village, is a bhatar, a village chief. But two are human beings. Tayor apohe, you take away the kingdom from the king, you take away the village from the village chief, both are same human beings. Simple example to reveal the absolute Ishwara Jiva. With samashti upadhi, with the macrocosmic upadhi, Ishwara, Hiranyagarbha, Virat. With the individual upadhi, Vishwa, Taijasa, Pragya. Individual body, Vishwa. Macrocosmic body, Virat. Can you stand apart from the Virat? Total mind, individual mind, Hiranyagarbha, Taijasa. Ishwara, Pragya. Can you stand apart from the totality? This is always inseparable until the individuality comes up and says, this is me. Are you getting that point, please? Inseparability, you understand the simplicity of it? Inseparability is the name of the game. You don't have to create inseparability. You don't have to create oneness. You can only create divisions. Do you understand? Do you really appreciate? You cannot create oneness. Oneness is already there. Divisions are created. Separation is created. Are you getting that point? Body has no sense. Dehoham iti dehona bhakti. I am the body doesn't say. The body cannot speak. Somebody speaks through the body. Right or wrong? I'm giving you the example. This one. Does it speak or does it amplify? The speaker doesn't speak. There is a speaker, but that doesn't speak. His name is speaker, huh? He doesn't speak. And this one amplifies. If the speech is good, you don't put garland around this bad boy. If the speech is bad, you don't throw no eggs, because this is religious class, potato, right? Think of it. Because this doesn't speak, this only amplifies. Have you seen that for yourself? Your body doesn't speak, your body amplifies. It amplifies your thought. You cannot speak a word which is not preceded by a thought. Please say something in Oriya, those who are not from Odisha. You speak Tamil. The guys who come from other parts of the world, let them talk Tamil. Why can't you speak? Speak. You cannot speak what your mind doesn't think. Are you getting that point, please? That is why languages are not spoken. So, in other words, this one only, the mouth, this voice box, amplifies. Eyes do not see. They help in seeing somebody inside. You see that mechanism? You really see that mechanism? Eyes do not decide to see. Ears don't decide to listen. They do not. Yeah, current off, so switch it off. I know, so switch it off so that the noise goes. This one. See how nice it is? Did the ear feel tired of sound the sound? Please see that. You must see every moment. Don't make meditation, spirituality, you know, devotion, wisdom, special moments of life. The rest of the time, fight with my husband, fight with my wife, fight with my brother, sister, everybody else. But Upanishad class? What is this? A waste of time. Jokers. You're joking with yourself. Every moment. You understand the point? Every moment. You can see it. Did the ear get tired of that noise? Did the ear get tired? The moment it comes in from inside, one suggestion comes. Terrible noise. I don't like this. Remove. I gave the grant. Thought said, okay. Thought is accepted. This one, speak it out. Bad boy. Close it up. Close it. How did it happen? From the eye? No, you must be conscious of what the thought comes. Are you conscious? The whole process. How many of you are aware? How many of you are aware? If you are not, you shall be stuck at the level of a thought, or the I thought, at the level of the world, completely destroyed. This listening will have no meaning whatsoever. That is why everybody listens, but not everybody gains. Like everybody worships. Today is Guru Purnima. Everybody worships gurus. Listen carefully. Everybody goes to temple, but everybody doesn't worship God. I'll give you the example. Please think of it. Everybody goes to temple. We think everybody worships God. No. There are million people go for a religious festival. The visit temple, visitors are million, worshippers one or two. God worshippers one or two. Why do you go to God? Last year I came here, I had told God, if my daughter gets married, I'll visit you again. So he's visiting not God, he's visiting because his dreams were fulfilled. I'll come to this temple if my disease is gone. So disease is cured, I come. Suppose my disease is not cured, I go to another god. So this year I go to Ardhanarishvara temple, it did not work. Then I go to Brihadishvara, what is his Vaidyeswaran Koil. That also, that worked, then I'll go there. So, but that did not work, Tirupati. That didn't work, Velangani. That didn't work, Ajmer Sharif. Are you getting that? Nothing worked, communist. Think of it, friends. Nobody visits temple. Visitors are many. Visitors are many. Worshippers are. Some people worship because their dreams were fulfilled. So, if your dreams are fulfilled, your wishes are fulfilled, you worship God. If your wishes are not fulfilled, you change the God. Whom are you worshipping? Whom are you worshipping? You are worshipping your wishes, your dreams. Are you getting that point, please? Think. This is at all levels. I'll explain to you. This is what the thought came to my room, in my room. I'll explain to you. Everybody doesn't worship God. I prayed God for a second house. I got it. Thank you. I'm worshipping God for the house, for the car, for the job, for the money, for the marriage, for the curing the disease. If it doesn't happen, you shall change that particular God. The real worshipper is, I worship him because I know how great he is. Why? He is all pervasive. If he is all pervasive, I cannot stand apart from him. How can he be all pervasive if I am left out? He is here. Therefore, you are the one continuously worshipping. Only one person worships. One person means whoever understands this, for him, worship is continuous. Pujate vishayo upabhoga rachana nidra samadhi sthiti. Pujate vishayo upabhoga rachana. O Lord, your worship is every sense perception, every sensation, every thought, whatever I experience is your worship, because every perception, sensation, thought is offered at the altar of consciousness. Atma tvam girijamati sahachara prana sariram gruham. O Ishwara, O Lord, Tvam Atma, you are myself. How are you going to escape the worship? Your living is a worship, every work is a worship, every action is worship. For other person, worshipping is an action. For most people, worshipping is an action. Just an action, like any other action. You are cooking, you are driving, you are singing, you are dancing, you are also worshipping. Tired of dancing, go into swimming. Tired of swimming, go into sleeping. Tired of sleeping, go into walking. Tired of walking, go into worshipping. Tired of worshipping, go into cooking. You are tired. A worshipper never gets tired. One who is one with Ishwara, can he get tired? Can you stop worshipping? See that. Everybody doesn't worship. Everybody visits a temple. Only that person worships when he knows God alone is. There is nothing other than him. Inseparable. Take it from any dimension. Love. Think of it, love. I love him, I love her. Everybody is a lover. Think, everybody is a lover. I love food, I love music, I love dance, I love traveling, I love counting money, I love my dog, I love my friend, I love my wife, I love my husband, I love my girlfriend, my boyfriend, I love my teacher, I love my father. Everybody is a lover. Listen carefully. Everybody loves. But those are not love. The true love is when you love yourself for who you are. Because when you love yourself for who you are, you shall love everything that you have. Everybody loves his, listen carefully. Everybody loves his wealth. How long? until the wealth becomes a trouble. You love your gold, how long? Until a person comes with a gun. Give your gold or die. What shall you say? Kill me? Leave my gold? Take it. Take it! So you say you love your gold, but you behave you love yourself. Are you getting that point? You say you love your father, mother, husband, wife, but get rid of every one of them once they are trouble. Why divorce comes? Why separation comes? Why friends fall apart? Listen carefully, friends. Because you really don't love them. You don't know how to love. Everybody loves, but everybody is not a true lover. Because they don't love themselves. When you love yourself, you cannot stop loving anything that you have. Are you getting that point, please? When you love yourself for who you are, you love your body for what it is, you love your mind for what it is, you love your poverty, you love your prosperity, you love your old age, you love your wealth, you love your youth, you love your everything you love. Why? Because you are love. Just like knowing, being one with God, every action is a worship. Pasyan, Shunvan, Spursan, Jigran, Asnan, Gachan, Swapan, Swasan, Pralapan, Visurjan, Unmishan, Nimishan, Iti Nakinchit Karomi Iti Yukta Manyeta Tattvavit. The one who knows the reality, seeing, hearing, tasting, touching, smelling, waking, dreaming, sleeping, doing everything, I don't do anything. There is only one absolute reality, and everything is a worship. Pujate Vishayopa Bhagavarachana Nidra Samadhi Sthiti. Even sleep is like Samadhi. Every action, Sanchara Padayo Pradakshina Vidhi. Wherever the feet go, O Lord, that is your Pradakshina. That is the circumambulation. Why? In God, every movement. Stutrani Sarvagiraha. Every word is your worship, is your chanting, is the Vedic mantras. There is nothing called mundane. Everything is divine. Every minute of life is a worship. As when you understand what the God is, and you remain inseparable from the totality, macrocosm, absolute, same way love. In your love, when I say I love somebody, in reality I love myself. And what is that self? When you recognize that for who you are, I have given you that in the beginning classes. Object of love is source of joy. Anything you like, if anything that gives you happiness, you love it. And anything that you love, anything that gives you happiness, you love it. And anything that you love, it has to give you happiness. When you start analyzing, ultimately I love myself, I must be the source of happiness. And since I am the source of happiness, I cannot escape loving myself. That holds true for every human being in this universe. So everybody loves himself, and when you love yourself, you love everybody. In self-love, are you getting that? In self-love, when you are loving yourself, there is no selfishness. If you love your body, you will hate others' body. If you love your wealth, you will hate wealthier person. You will be arrogant because the other person is poor. But if you love yourself for who you are, and you accept everything that you have, you shall love everybody for who they are, and accept them for what they have. Do you know why you go through major upheaval inside yourself? It's like a major earthquake inside yourself. Every moment you are going through convulsions. That fellow is like that. She is like that. He is like that. That fellow is like that. Hey, what about you? Blinker. A total blinker. But when you remove that, and when you see yourself, who I am is so beautiful, I can't escape loving myself. I am the love. So everybody is a lover, but one who loves himself is true lover. Everybody is a worshipper, but one who sees God alone is existing is a true worshipper. Are you getting that point? In Guru Purnima day, everybody worships Guru for different reasons. Everybody worships. Listen carefully. Just like you worship your father for different reasons. You worship your mother for different reasons. You like your mother because she just wrote the whole property in your name. Mommy. The father gave you the whole property. Papa. Suppose the father gave you the one son and not this son. One daughter and not this daughter. Try. The person who did not give, ask him to worship. Crook. Crook. He's an idiot. Cuckoo. Needs psychological help. Father, no? Please understand. That's true for every sphere of life. Everybody doesn't worship Guru. Coming to the Guru, I got introduced to somebody very nice. Thank you. He's very thankful for a better reason. I come to the Guru, I got a job in America. Through somebody, I got a job. Thank you. He also worships. He's not worshipping Guru. Coming through somebody, oh, I could go around some places. Coming through the teacher, I got a car. Very nice. Listen carefully. And by chance they see somebody got a bigger car than them, or somebody got more important than them, again, Guru gets the beating. Somebody more important, less important. Or I was nobody, but coming around the Guru, I became somebody. Very important. But if somebody becomes a greater somebody, then you become terribly nobody. You understand? Horrible thing happens. The true worshipper of a Guru is who? One who knows. Satchidanandam Vedatitam Jagadguru. One who knows that having come across the teacher, now I know myself. Satchidanandam. I am the absolute. I am the all pervasive. I am aham asmi sadabhami kadachit nahamapya. Aham asmi. I am always existing, always shining. Never I hate myself. I am the love. One who knows that. Can you stop worshipping? For that worshipping doesn't mean only come and throw one flower at his head. You don't know. Life is a continuous gratitude. He is a true worshipper. As I told you in the morning class, thousands of people may visit, but thousands are not disciples, shishyas. One who sees the truth, he is a student. The Guru has no student. Listen carefully. Once he is free from the role, will he condemn himself to the role of a guru? Think, one who is free from every role, nirguna nirvikara, will he be stupid enough to condemn himself to a role called a guru? Like the other day one person asked me, Swamiji, are you a guru? My straight question to him is, are you a disciple? Are you a student? If you are not a student, what guru? It's like asking, are you a wife? What nonsense. Whose wife? Are you a husband? Think of it. No person assumes the role of a guru. If there is a student, he invokes a guru. That is why in Upanishads, when you see that, Bhrugurvai Varuni Varunam Pitaram Upasasara Adihi Vagavo Brahmeti. Bhrugurvai Varuna, Varuni, Varunasya Pratyapuvan, Varuni, Bhrugu, he goes to the father. Bhrugurvai Varuni, Varunam Pitaram Upasasara, he goes to his father Varuna. And he says, Adihi Bhagavo Brahmeti, he doesn't say Papa, Daddy, Appa, no. Oh, father, teach me? No. When you are going for the knowledge, is no but the father. Adihi Bhagavan, O Bhagavan, O worshipful one, the Guru. Adihi, Shankara comments so beautifully. Adihi means what? Teach. Mama Anugrahartham Smara. Please, for my sake, in order to bless me, please remember. You don't need words to remember yourself. You are always yourself. But if to teach, if you become Dakshinamurti, total silence, how am I going to understand? So remember these thoughts. For my sake, remember. The teacher is existing without a student. But the student will not be a student unless he learns. Are you getting that point, please? How fantastic it is. The existence of a teacher doesn't depend upon a student. Existence of the guru depends on himself. Like existence, when the student understands also, he will understand the same thing. That is why ultimately that conundrum, in that puzzle, everything disappears. Na guru naiva shishyaha chidananda rupa shivoham shivo. When the student comes, he accepts the teacher. Why? Because the ahankar, listen carefully, the ahankar, the I, gets tired of everything in life. Worshipping, tired, false worship. Loving, tired, false love. Achieving, tired, false achievement. That is why until the I gets tired, you cannot teach. If one of those roles or other, jati, niti, kula, gotra, nama, rupa, guna, if one of those things you are stuck on, you will not understand. Don't worry about it. Are you getting that point, please? Somewhere deep within, your relative identity has hijacked the absolute. Somewhere, look at yourself. If you are finding it difficult, ask yourself which role you have fallen in love. You are stuck to PhD, Prime Minister, King, Village Chief, a smart person. Whichever. Look at yourself, please. Something somewhere which you shall resist to give up. Something which you think gives you importance is so fragile. Or else, why is it difficult that you cannot give up? Understand? It's not difficult to give up the ahankar. It's difficult to give up what ahankar holds on to. Think. Because ahankar, this I thought, is a simple thought. It is now entangled. What it has hold on to, it has created a knot. Simple I is not a problem. Are you getting that point, please? Simple I is not a problem. I am rich. Poor. Jati, niti, kula, gotra. You are getting that point. Anything. Or I am bound. I am a holy man. I don't need all these things. Think. As I am talking to you, you shall feel stripped inside. Because whatever you are holding on to is not worth holding on to. That is why even while listening, as you are listening, if the teaching is fantastic, while listening, you shall disappear. The person says, yes, that's right. You see it for yourself. And to be me, I don't need any of these things. None of these things. So just as when visitors are many, not worshippers. These worshippers are also many if they are worshipping for a particular reason to God. But I worship because I worship. He alone is. If I don't fall for that, what else am I going to fall for? Again, ultimately, like in Kamsi, in your Parapuja, Advaye Sachidanande Nirvikalpeka Rupini, Sthite Adhitya Bhavesmin Katham Puja Vidihate. O Lord, how do I worship you? Because Advaye, in that one without a second, Nirvikalpeka Rupini, when there is no vikalpa, no modifications, no divisions of any kind, only one absolute, Katham puja vidhyate. How the puja is possible? Because there is no difference between, no distance between, no separation between altar of worship and the worshipper. O Lord, you have swallowed it all. When Bali is pushed into the Netherlands, Vishnu Trivikrama, he alone is existing. And you see it for yourself. So for you, which moment worship? Every moment is a moment of worship. Same thing in love. Every moment you are in love with yourself, therefore love with the whole universe. So everybody loves, but everybody is not a true lover because they don't love the object for object's sake. When you love the, are you getting that? When you love something for its own sake, you are a true lover. You love the flower because it gives you happiness. Better flower, you'll drop it. Better object, better things, that is why you go on dropping. Your love is not constant. So when you love somebody, you love only one thing. You love the whole universe. But nobody feels unloved. That is the beauty. You love the whole universe. Everything as it is. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. This is beautiful. That's also beautiful. Why? For its own sake. Which is better? Which is better? There is no better. Everything has its own place. Same way also. Who worships the teacher? Is the guru, when you think of this, when you think of the guru, is not a person. Immediately the man will say, oh yes Swami, that's right. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo, Maheshwara. Guru is Brahma, Guru is Vishnu, Guru is Maheshwara. Some people worship him as what? Tameva Mata Japita, you are a father, you are a mother. So some people worship Guru as a father figure. Suppose he doesn't satisfy some of your needs, he is finished. Somebody worshipped as a mother figure, somebody as a friend, somebody as something else. All these things are possible only if you recognize the teacher as the truth of your own self. Until that, if you stick to one particular role, why you like the person? Please understand, friends. Why you like the person? Because through him I got a job. No good. Because of him today I am temple trustee. No good. Because of him something happened to me. No good. But because of him, today I am Sachidananda Brahma. He pointed out the reality to myself. My God, your gratitude is endless. Think of it, friends. Please think of it. Why the teacher is known as Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara? Because, understand, the vehicle is named after the destination. The vehicle. You go to Mapsal bus stand, what is Coimbatore? You go to Coimbatore, the fellows will be shouting, Tanjavur, 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 Mayiladurai, 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 Madurai, Madurai, Madurai. Now what nonsense? What is Madurai, Mayiladurai, Tanjavur in, what is that? Salem, in that Coimbatore bus stand. The buses are there and they are named after the destination. If you get into the bus with Tanjavur, and don't get down in between Tanjavur. You get down, get in the bus to Madurai, you shall reach there. The buses are named after the destination. The Guru is named after the destination. His Brahma, his Vishnu, his Maheshwara, is everything. Why? Because if you hold on to that and see what he shows, you shall be the absolute. The wrong buses are, you get into a bus is going to Mayiladurai but is written Tanjavur. Then you are in deep trouble. Like some people got into trouble recently. They are coming in a train. They got into the Howrah train to come to Madras. How do you like it? The train is standing on the platform. Which way it moves, you don't know. With the engines, you don't see. So you got to, the train is standing, therefore get in. Because train is standing, should you get in? Or you should see in which direction, which destination the train goes. Because somebody teaching, I come to attend the classes. But what is the destination? Holding the nose. You will end up as the nose holder. You go to another class going on, what is that? Singing and dancing and fasting and feasting. Okay, you'll end up as a singing and dancing and fasting and feasting. Another person will go there, oh, language, Sanskrit, English, Telugu, Tamil, no. Yes, you'll be a linguist, you'll not be truth. Why I'm picking up this, now we have finished Bhagavad Gita. Here only Bhagavad Gita, nothing else. Okay, stuck in Bhagavad Gita. You have come to recognize the superiority of a text. For God's sake. Which text is important? Every text is important. Which one is important? Every one is important if they reveal the truth. To understand the truth, how many words you need? How many? Only one word. I am not telling. Sarve vada yat padamamanandi. Tapamsi sarvani chayat vadandi. Yadi chanto brahmacharyam charanti tatte padam sangrahena prabhakshe om iti etat. Only one word, om. What is that om? A, u, or aham iti etat. A, ha, Now the om fanatics, aham is not. How can you say that? Om and aham, mithyasam irikila. Nonsense. A, ha, So aham is a dirty word, then aham brahmasmi is a useless statement. Think of it, friends, because people become language fanatic, book fanatic, practice fanatic. Come back to yourself. The one who is becoming fanatic, that person should change. Why are you asking him to change his adherence or change his obsession to one word for another? Change him. Previously I was stuck on worship, now I am stuck on breathing. Previously I was stuck on breathing, now I am stuck on, you know, tired of this, you get tired of that. Tired of puja, you go to tired of, you know, chanting or singing. Tired of chanting, singing, simply tired, sitting down quiet. Tired of sitting down quiet, do some heavy pilgrimage. Should you think of it? Why can't just be? Then choose which one, whichever you like. I'm very happy with myself, but I want to go to Himalayan mountain for a pilgrimage. Go. But if you think by going for a pilgrimage you shall be happy, don't worry. That will not work. I'm very happy, but I want to do some pranic exercise. Do. Why? Body will be healthy. Fantastic. Do. But by doing pranayama, if you want to be immortal, that will not work. That I shall be happy, that will not work. Everything has a place. Therefore, friends, we cannot dismiss it. Everything has a place, but therefore that does not mean that is the absolute. Don't hold on to it. In the relative world, there is nothing absolute. Your roles are relative. Please, always in life. Have you not seen it? Always in life. In a theater, front row is best. In movie, in a theater, you can go in the front row. That is the highest ticket. Movie. When the flood comes, fish eats the ant. When the water goes, ants eat the fish. Right or wrong? So who is more powerful, fish or the ant? Think, friends. Oil is needed to make a soap. Soap is needed to remove the oil. Which one is right? You understand the examples of life? How fantastic it is. Relative, relative, relative. For one relative identity, you want to dismiss everybody? Everything? I'm superior? What way? Only when you appreciate yourself being who you are, you accept every relative identity about yourself. Now I'm young, now I'm old. Happily young, happily old. Happily rich, happily poor. Happily healthy, happily diseased. Happily living, happily dying. You don't need a 2 days extension, 1 more year extension. Why do you want an extension? 70 years waste. Right? Why do you want to live longer, 1 year more? For what? Edik extension. For what extension? Do we waste a little more time? Anna dhansa? To destroy some more food stuff in this world? Happy. It's like people who go to temple. Big queue. That 1 minute, how desperate they are. The fellow in the, you don't want to move. Until you are on the back seat, you are moving. Everybody should move. Everybody should. The moment you go to the center, now nothing should move. Now other one is pushing you. Why don't you just go that per second, enjoy and work out? Then you don't have to be so very cajoling and, you know, so very, you know, sort of requesting and praying and begging to that priest. Can I stand? Can I? That priest has been standing 24/365, idiot. Right? Think of it. That 1 minute, stand like a king. Namaste. Because you want to see the form. Formless, you don't want to go anywhere. Are you getting that point? But for that little minute, people pay 100,000 rupees, Surya Astamana Puja, 400,000 rupees. And that is booked for 10 years, you can't get a chance also. People feel very proud, you know. We went there and we stood for 4 hours. You can stood for life, nothing will happen. Don't worry. Think, friends. You must think. If you think by just by looking at the vision of Krishna, everything will be fine. Krishna was living during the time of Mahabharata, right? If you accept it. All people are seeing him. How come Duryodhana never changed? Fought with him. And today you think, if only I can by vision. Last night I slept, Krishna came to my mind, tickled me. Think of it. This is no disrespect to Krishna. This is disrespect to, not disrespect, some hammering on your stupid intellect. If Krishna is, just look at him, everything is fine. That during that time, everybody should have been liberated just like that. Why killing Krishna? What is that boy, Kamsa, Jarasandha, Shishupala, these Kauravas? What is that for wasting? Just stand there mesmerized. Everybody changes. Okay, you take the kingdom, I'm going home. It didn't happen. So when you see that, when you see the God, both Saguna and Nirguna, is in formless absolute, that's myself. In form, my body is an inseparable part of it. So every moment is in worship. Atma tum mirijamati sahachara prana. Oh Lord, you are myself. The mind is Girija, Parvati, the concept. Sahachara prana, the pranic forces, sahachara, attendants. Sariram guham, this body, oh Lord, is the temple. Deha devalaya prakta dehi devo maheshwa. Pujate visayopa bhoga rachana. Every moment, what all I experience, that is your worship, O Lord. Nidra samadhi sthiti. Your sleep is like nidra. Sanchara padayo pradakshina vidhi. As I walk around, every footstep I take is a circumambulation. You alone are existing. Pujate visayopa pradakshina vidhi. Stotrani sarvagira. Every word is your stotram, your worship, O Lord. Yadyat karma karma. How long, how much can I tell, O Lord? Yadyat karma karomi. Whatever action done through this, sambho, O Lord, tava aradhana, your worship. Every moment is your worship. So how many worshippers are there in this world? One who sees God alone is a true worshipper. How many lovers are in this world? One who really loves himself or who he is. How many guru disciples are there? Guru puja. How many people really worship the teacher? One who knows Satchidanandam, Vedatitam, Nityam, Purnam, Nirakaram, Nirgunam, Sarvasanstitam. One who knows it, he becomes a disciple. Listen, I told you this morning, thousands visit the teacher, one who knows, understands, he is the disciple, he is the student, because he can't forget. When shall you worship the teacher? Continuously. Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vivahagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtayenam Dakshinamurti Namaskar. Why? Ishvara Guru Atma Iti Murti Veda Vibhaga. One who destroys this division, Ishwara, God, Guru, the teacher, Atma, me. These three divisions, there are not three things. There is only Vyomavat Bhakta Dehaya, like it's like space, which is one without second, all pervasiveness. Like Vyomavat, like space, all pervasiveness, in which Ishvara, Guru, Atma, all the three are lost. Your worship, one day, 365 days. The person who comes for something else, just like you drop one God, go to another God. Drop one object of love to another object of love. which is necessary in the world, because you need relative things. If one God didn't work, other God will do that. That is because your needs are relative needs. Same thing. If a person really get the knowledge absolute, after that, what shall he see for the issue, for the teacher? What shall he ask for it? Suppose the teacher cannot give something relative, honorably disappear. Why? I came for the knowledge, I got it, but this man is not capable of giving me a kingdom. I am going. But he is my teacher. I came to this person, I got this knowledge, but this man is not capable of giving me another 1 acre of land. Because he is into Brahma Vidya always. He doesn't have the resources. But he is my teacher. I move out. But the people who come for the absolute knowledge, but somewhere lose track and give the importance to relative roles of life, and when they don't get that importance, what happens? Now they say the teacher is useless. No, your desires are insatiable. Understand? Such a person can be around the teacher, but he is not a disciple. He is not a shishya. Not a shiksha yogya. What is shishya? Shishya means shiksha yogya, who is fit to be taught. To whom shall you teach? One who is tired of jati, niti, kula, gotra, nama, rupa, guna. You cannot teach somebody who is sticking onto something. Are you getting that point? How do you teach him? Because he is desperately holding on to something. The teacher says, you are the absolute. He says, I'm not interested. I want to get information about all the Upanishads and go back to the world as a scholar. This is not the place. I want to know all the grammar. Go to some other place. I want to do the puja, worship, chanting. Some other place. Are you interested in yourself? Who you are? That is the tradition. The real guru is one who helps us to be ourselves. Like in Vichar Sagara, Parvati and Shiva, there is a talk, conversation between the two. And what Bhagavan Shiva says, Bahabaha Guravaha Santi Shishya Vitta Apaharaka Durlabhoyam Gurur Devi Shishya Rut Tapaharaka. Shiva talks to Parvati. Bahavaha Guravaha Santi. There are many, many teachers, so-called teachers. Because everybody is a teacher, like everybody is a disciple, like everybody is a worshipper. People go to worship, worshipper. The priest is worshipping, also worshipper. What is the difference between the two? One is begging, other is a facilitator. Both are useless. Are you getting that point? One is average person goes for what? Doesn't go there to say, God, you are myself. No. He goes to ask for something. This person is facilitator. He doesn't know the language. You want to write an application to the managing director? I want to write a letter to managing director. I don't know. So there is a letter writer sitting down there. He shall write for me the letter. What is that? You understand? So God is sitting down there. I want to pray for something, but they say, I don't know how to pray because I don't have the language. Sanskrit language I don't have, or Tamil language I don't have. Or this methodology you don't have, hand this way, that way, you know, I don't know. You don't have that. So there is one person facilitating. So is he a worshipper? Because he is not worshipping for himself, he is worshipping for somebody. Why? With what this somebody is begging for, he is going to get it, commission. Right or wrong? No. Language seems to be very, very, sounds may be very rigid. But understand, friends, what is going on? God needs a middleman. Between me and the God, you need a middleman. Why? Because online application. Yeah, nowadays is online application, no? So you don't know how to type it in the computer. So fix up somebody who can do it for you, right? So it has to be online application. It must be correctly put. Adya Brahmana, Ditya Bharati, Sveta Varahakalpi, Vaivasvata Mandandri, Meruho, Dakshina Parshri, Uttara Parshri, whatever it is. So pakka computerized application form. You don't know, nothing will work. You say, God, I'm doing that, God will not listen to you. Why? Because computerized, online. How ridiculous, eh? Think of it, friends. Therefore, I'm not telling that you should not do it. For God's sake, do it. Celebrations, chantings, oof. We need it. Suppose you don't need to do worship, all these things, always be yourself, whatever life it will be. It's nice, celebration. Shaguna, Nirguna, that is why the tradition is so fantastic. But don't replace the absolute wisdom with some relative action. It's fantastic. So, one who sees what the teacher shows, being himself. And when you recognize it, your gratitude is permanent. Whether you see him, don't see him, visit him, don't visit him, you are touched forever. Told you Ishwara. There are two standpoints. We'll see it later on in the afternoon. Absolute and relative. You go to the teacher for absolute gain, not for relative things. If relative things come, that's okay. Doesn't come, not necessary. You go to Ishwara for what? Absolute. On the process, something relative, good thing happens, beautiful. Relative being what it is, something wrong also can happen. Rama himself, incarnate, he enjoyed the kingdom, suffered the banishment also. In the ordinary language of the person, how do you know he suffered? He enjoyed maybe the forest for 14 years. These are relative things. Krishna, absolute, relative. And how many things he suffered? Fighting his battle, that man's battle, this man's battle, protecting this, protecting that. So relative things will be always this way, that way. But never lose sight of the absolution, the coming to a teacher. The first purpose is absolute, who I am. I want to know who I am. Then relative gains, there may be, may not be. If it is there, beautiful. Is not there also, beautiful. But if it is not there, like people throw the God into the temple, throw the God into the river. You throw the object of love, person throws the teacher. He doesn't know that because just because you throw it away, God doesn't get thrown away. You understand the point? When you say, the cow is lost, who is lost? You are the cow. When you say, the key is missing, who is missing? You are the key. The key has no sense of missing. You have the sense of missing. When you say, the cow is lost, the cow doesn't feel lost. Cow is rambling around. You feel lost that you are cow. So you think you have dismissed the God. He smiles. You think you have dismissed the Guru. Madhava, Madhava. Amazing wisdom, sir. One who listens to this, he alone can write these verses. One who has written these verses is not just to praise Guru, to praise himself. Do you understand what I am talking? You pass it on the name of the Guru. You pass it in the name of the tradition. But ultimately, what you speak reflects the absolute wisdom. Because only when you see the greatness of the Guru, how will you see the greatness of Guru? Only when you see the greatness of yourself. How do you see the greatness of God? Will you see the greatness of God in yourself? Yes, that's right. At once, nirguna and shaguna. So it begins with yourself, ends with yourself. Please close your eyes.